today is Menaris disease. For Menaris disease, this is an inner ear disorder that mostly affects one ear of a person. It may also occur at any age, but most books says that it's in between 20 to 50, or in other books, it's 50 to 60 years old. The cause is not yet understood, but it's theorized that the abnormal amount of fluid in the ear or the endolymph causes the Menaris disease manifestations. So this abnormal amount of fluid in the ear are from improper fluid drainage, abnormal immune response, allergies, viral infections, head trauma, or migraines. For our signs and symptoms, this occurs if there's a disturbance in the vestibular canal of our ear, the one that is responsible for our balance, and for the cochlea, which is responsible for our hearing. For the recurrent episodes of vertigo, there is at least twice of recurrence of the vertigo, and it lasts for 20 minutes. And this happens when there's a disturbance in the vestibular canals of our ear. And this hearing loss, ringing in the ear, feeling of fullness in the ear, happens when there's a cochlear disturbance in our ear. So the hearing loss is usually occurs in adults, but when it happens for us teenagers and we experience other signs and symptoms, this may mean that we have Menaris disease. Also, for the ringing of in the ear, is medical term is tinnitus. For the feeling of fullness in the ear, usually when we swim, we feel this one. So for the treatments, usually the otolaryngologist is the one responsible for the diagnosis or giving the medications of Menaris disease. But then these otolaryngologists are also known as the ear, nose, and throat doctors or the ENT doctors. So first, there's no definitive test or single symptom that the doctor can use to make the diagnosis. And the second note, so how do doctors diagnose Menaris disease? These are the following. The doctor's diagnosis are based upon the medical history of the client, as well as if there's a presence of the following. The two or more episodes of vertigo lasting at least 20 minutes each, tinnitus, temporary hearing loss, or a feeling of fullness in the ear.
So for the treatment, there are a lot of things treatment to relieve the symptoms of dizziness and shorten the attack, such as diazepam and lorazepam and others. Now, also, the patient has to restrict some salt in the diet and also use diuretics as water pills. Now, the doctor might also prescribe diuretics for the patient to relieve some dizziness and fluid accumulation in the ear. Now, there are some dietary and behavioral changes the patient needs to work on. These are certain things that the patient takes, like limiting of caffeine, chocolates, and alcohol. And the patient also has to stop smoking. If the patient is a smoker, he or she has to quit smoking. See, no smoking. And the patient also needs some therapy, such as cognitive therapy, which helps the coping mechanism, like for expecting the attacks, like patients that normally have the attacks, seldom attack. So the patient needs cognitive therapy to maintain the body coping mechanism. And also there are some injections that the doctor or the nurse might prescribed for the patient, which are also like gentamicin and corticosteroids. Now, there are some pressure pulse treatments which may add on the endolymph, which is the accumulation of fluid in the ear, to prevent dizziness, which will also be prescribed by the doctor. Now, there are some certain surgical management for Menaris disease, such as the compression of endolymphatic sac, cutting of the vestibular nerve, and also the nursing management. The nurse should always provide nursing care during the attack and also instruct the client on self-care instructions to control the number of the attacks. Also, the nurse should discuss, prepare, and assist the client with surgical instruction. Always promote safety in case of dizziness. Thank you. Thank you for listening. I'm happy to teach you about Menaris disease. I hope you learned more.